Good morning from Beijing. Right now it's about 6:19, breakfast time here and dinner time at home. I had a restful night here in the Ritz-Carlton, and I tell you, the feeling, the ambience, just feel like royalty. You feel like a king once you are in this hotel establishment. One thing I must caution you though, if for those who wish to travel here in China, some creature comforts of home may not be available to you here. One thing I do notice, that you cannot access Facebook, YouTube, Hulu TV, and the like. And that will take some getting used to, but I'm pretty sure there are some other ways around it. But for now, I'm going to have some breakfast and see the Great Wall today.
Definition compared to the fancy hotels and the restaurants,
yes,
and being kind of secluded from.
Okay, the biggest difference between China and the Western countries is the middle class. We have a lot of rich people, but a lot of poor people. The biggest difference is the gap between the rich and the poor. Our middle class not has the majority part. Like in big cities, people's life are quite good. But if you visit a village or a mountain area, people's life there is still not very good. We are improving now, but we need time because we have so many people. Only in Beijing we have 19 million.
Wow.
So it's very crowded, but the whole country we got 1.5 million.
Well, I find that when I stayed here overnight, I was wanted to go to Facebook, you know.
It
to,
was blocked.
It was blocked because I wanted to show my friends, like, hey, I'm here. Why is the government
block it?
Like, I mean, is it more so a political reason, or do you think it's out of fear?
Both. One is the political reason. The other one is about the economy, because they want to protect our own website. We have a similar website called Renren, similar, exactly same as Facebook. They want to get ours, use it more. And the other reason they said they are going to try to stop terrorists to get in touch with each other. That's the saying up among the young people. But we are not sure. Because, you know, in China we have only one party called Communist Party.
Yes.
So everything we just follow. Because we can't vote.
You can't vote?
We can't.
You
only
cannot
the
vote?
Party member, they can vote. the citizens, we don't have the right to vote. We only follow who will be the next one.
Wow.
But all the party was called Communist Party, but actually economy, everything is capitalism, similar.
So how did one become part of the Communist Party if they could? Or is that like an inside closed deal?
Yeah.
Is that connected? Or?
Both of them. If you want to become an official or anyone in the government, you must be a party member. When we were in the high school or university, if you study very good and behave very good and join a lot of activities, you can write a letter to show what's your feeling. Then they need to watch your behaviors. If you are qualified, they can give you a party member's seat. But if a lot of people, if you want to do business or go outside very often, mostly they don't choose to be a party member because sometimes there are some limitations.
Oh, I see.
And in Beijing City, it can be the best city for the tour because it has the old history and modern things both. Like, have you been to Hong Kong or Shanghai?
Those are the two places I will visit after here.
Oh, after Beijing. So when you go there, you can feel it's totally different because those cities are similar with some of yours, with modern buildings, big shopping mall, that's it. Because
right.
Our business center. But here we have the old history and modern things. And totally we have 16 districts and 2 counties. Forbidden City is in the city center,
mm-hmm.
and it's a rectangular shape. Then it's the second ring road, third until to the sixth. All the ring roads, they are in a square shape.
That's it.
They call it ring road, but it's a square shape.
Oh, okay.
Because more easy for the traffic.
Gotcha.
On the ring road, no traffic lights.
Oh, gotcha.
So it's more faster. But still, the traffic here is bad, especially on rush hour.
Wow.
Now you feel it, right?
Yes, yes.
So that's the whole city's arrangement. And all Chinese constructions, we like to make everything symmetry.
Gotcha.
Did you find that? If you saw in the hotel's lobby, if you see a flower vase or a chair on the left, you must find it exactly similar on the right side.
Oh.
Because we believe the balance between yin and yang. The most popular religion here is Buddhism and Taoism.
Gotcha.
And in the Buddhism, odd numbers are lucky numbers.
Odd numbers are lucky numbers.
Yes.
Wow.
So we always use 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. That's in the Buddhism. And in the Buddhism, everyone believes we should suffer the pain of rebirth.
Mm.
We have 2 main Buddhas. One is Happy Buddha. Have you seen him before? A guy who with a big belly. And
yes, yes, that one.
Smile. But actually, we consider him not a religious guy, just a happy guy for good luck. Because girls, we like him.
Uh-huh.
Girls, we like to talk. We like gossip. That means we need to learn from the man, forget the tiny things.
Oh.
That's why we like him. And we have the other female Buddha called the God of Mercy. She is a female and very slim.
Oh.
And the boys like her. Because you are always busy about business.
Yes.
And it's easy for you to forget how to take care of family or others. It means you need to learn from the girl.
So this is the real China.
The village, countryside.
This is the countryside.
Like the part of the wall is from the local village. Gardens.
Oh, fruit gardens.
This countryside, they have the shuttle bus to the city, but the subway comes to Beijing.
foothills of the Great Wall of China, so we're about to take a walk up and see the tour, and I'd like to meet our tour guide.
Hi.
Lucy will be our tour guide for the Great Wall tour, and she'll be kind enough to give us some information about the history and the culture of the Great Wall of China. What is this particular wall called?
Mu Tie U.
Mu Tie U?
Mu Tie U.
Mu Tie U.
U.
Mu Tie U.
Yes.
Okay. This is the Great Wall of Mu Tie U.
Yes.
Oh.
That's the outer side. Like the green color bricks there are the new one. The government renovated. And the yellow still in the original. The wall itself is not very high, but it has a very deep base. The height of the base, the average one is 7.5 meters. And all the bricks, they are not even, because they don't have any cutting machine or trucks, only by hand.
They're not even.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Hi. What's your name again?
Jane.
I'm Derek.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And what is the first impression when you first came?
It definitely surpassed all my expectations. It's incredible. It's absolutely incredible. And you know, it's the first time you read the history books, you kind of see it, but you don't really believe it until you get here. And so sick.
Wow. Awesome. Yeah. Wow. I pretty much share the same sentiment that you have. Mm-hmm. For years, since I was a kid, I used to read the books, watch television, but as soon as you set foot, it gives you a whole different perspective, perspective that you haven't seen before.
Right.
And to be able to touch it, feel it, and to step foot on it, it just gives you a whole new different outlook. You know, and we're standing on history.
Right, exactly. Like, for human potential, you know, like, it's just like, there's so much potential here, you know?
Wow.
And it just shows you how, like, you know, for every stone there was definitely, like, what was it, like, every stone for a man or something, man's life.
Yeah.
So it's just like...
Wow. And you are from New York.
Yeah, I'm from New York.
Wow, how cool
was
it?
Born and raised, yeah, isn't that cool? Yeah.
So this is actually your first time here in China?
First time in Beijing. First time on the Great Wall. And second time in China overall.
Okay,
yeah.
Great. Okay. Spectacular view from up top of the Great Wall. Absolutely amazing. Once again, it's something you read in textbooks, in documentary, but to set foot on the actual Great Wall itself is absolutely impressive. Well, I'm glad to be here. I'm glad that I made this journey. Part of one of my four stops. And nothing I've ever seen before. So, glad to make this trip.
This coalition technique actually can be traced back to the Yuan Dynasty about 800 years ago. But the art of making reach this peak during Ming Dynasty, that's about 500 years ago. In the Ming Dynasty, the emperor, he liked it very much. He really made it by himself. So the triple wire for the Ming Empire is all cloistered. And it needs about 6 steps to complete. First step, they use the copper as base so they don't break. Then take a lot of copper wires on copper body to make the pattern. The colors, they are from the stone, natural color. They put colors in the little compartments and soldering, then the color can stick on copper body. But in the high temperature, the stone pattern shrinks. So they keep eye color. So that feeding and firing 2 steps will keep doing 8 times. In the 5th step, it will be polished by stones and charcoal. Stone making small charcoal and shadow. In the last step, there will be gold plate. So the copper part is covered with gold. Copper wires also cover with gold, so it won't get rusty. Now the machine is like this video. Some different shapes of mold. At first, they put copper pieces around the mold. Then they use a hammer to pound them to make different parts. Then they scour them together. So this one is butter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 pieces together. It's just like the work of the castles. So now let me show you the second step. This is this. So they should keep eye color. So that feeding, firing, two steps, keep doing 8 times. That blue is a traditional color. In the free market, there are some things machine made. It's only one layer. Then the color is easy to come out. Here we do 8 layers. So that better quality. Mm. Okay, now let me show the next step. Flatten. By her, she bend wires into the shapes, so she glue them on the base, then she put the color inside. Then it will be covered with resin.
Maybe you can find something you like. China, and about to head back to the airport.
Cool.
And had a great time here. This is the Great Wall of China. And I had my pleasant stay here. It was absolutely wonderful.
Okay.
But that ends.